Hey everyone, Russell here. If you're teaching in Microsoft Teams and you've already set the permissions for some of your students, but you'd like to go in and change those, you totally can, and I will show you how. But before I do, I want to let you know that you can reach out with any questions you have about this video or any others. Okay, let me show you how you can change some of these options in Microsoft Teams. Sign into office.com and click on the Microsoft Teams app. Here, you'll see all of my teams. I'm gonna click on the English 10 ellipsis and choose Manage Team. When the members page loads, pick the caret by the members and guests and expand the list to see all the members in your team. When the list populates, find the name of the person you want to be an owner and select the down arrow by member and choose owner. Here's a quick side note. If you need an explanation over the difference in permissions between an owner and a member, I link to that in the description as well. Now, once the status changes, the new owner will appear in the owner section of the page. If you need to delete a member of the team, select the X by the member. You can also mute all your students by selecting the mute students at the top of the list of members. Or if you only want to mute one or a couple students, you can select the box in the mute students column by the individual student's name. Now, if you need to modify even more, go to the settings to further control the conversations. You can determine whether members can create or delete channels, tabs, messages, and more. You can also decide if members can use app mentions. Last, in the fun stuff section, you can decide whether members are permitted to use gifs, stickers, and memes, and if you let them, even which filter should be applied. But that's it. So sometimes you will need to take action to make sure that your students' conversations are respectful and productive and focused on classroom goals. So this was just a quick snapshot of how to use permissions to help you do that. I've added a few other links to ways to establish guidelines that can help you in this remote learning environment. Now to questions. Online learning can present unique student safety challenges. So you've been asking a lot of questions about safety. So we gathered teams for education best practices for both administrators and educators to set up safety policies and administer meetings and channels with the recommended controls. This online resource helps you admins and educators keep your students safe. Okay, that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. I'm here every Monday and Thursday. Be bold, keep learning, and we'll see you next time.